Let's write down addition of Br2 in cyclic alkene. Addition of Br2 in cyclic alkene forms enantiomeric pair. Okay. So since alkene, you will always get enantiomers. Br2 with CCl4. This reaction takes place in the inert solvent carbon tetrachloride. This is the addition of Br from the opposite side.
So why is it sin over here and anti over there? What's the...
Because it is, see, it is trans.
So, but like, what's the mechanism?
Mechanism is, you'll get the same thing here. See, like this, Br, CH3 here, H here, CH3 here. Okay. Now this Br minus will attack from this side and this goes up. Because this methyl group, no. This side attack is sterically hindered. So back side is attacked. It goes up, so both sides Br2 will attach. Or if it attacks from this side. Okay. Okay. The attack will be preferred over here. Because you see you have methyl group here this side. And this ring opens up like this. So this attacks from this side. You see Br group interacting from this side. And this bond comes over here. So we have two Br molecules from this side.
So but then if it attacks from that side, you can still open
this
side,
this side. This side.
So but if it attacks from that side, you can still open up that bond with Br.
This one.
Yeah.
This one. And so if you attack from this side, this side is not possible because we have methyl here. So if this bond gets open, right? And when you convert, this is Sauer's position, right? And when you convert this into fission, you'll get both Br groups on the same side because the carbon atom and this carbon atom, the configuration must be same. So you must have done the.
So why does it have to be the same? Why does it happen?
No, you see, this is Sauer's, this is fission.
Yeah.
So we are converting this into this.
Yeah.
So when you convert this, you'll get this only, to have the same configuration in this carbon atom. Now the point is, you should know the conversion of Sauer's into, this Sauer's into fission. You must have done this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this you have to do. Then only you'll get two Br on the same side. So it's not like I'm attaching Br from the same side on this carbon atom. These two carbon Br minus will attack, you'll get two product, Sauer's projection. When you convert that into this fissure, you'll get this component. Okay? This conversion you know. Right?
Yes, sir.
So that is what you have to do over there. Here if you do, you'll get both Br on the opposite side. You must have the same configuration of this carbon atom and this carbon atom. Okay? Right. You must have discussed this into Newman also. Newman into fissure. Right, all these things conversion issues. Okay, so all these things when you draw the structure and then when you convert this into fissure, you'll get the same molecule like that. But to memorize this, like I said, cat and tail you have to remember, right? Cis addition, trio, trans addition, erythro. Cyclic alkene always gives you enantiomeric pair. Okay, you must remember. Next, write down addition of hydrogen halide. Oh, you'll get enantiomeric pairing. One Br here you write down into the plane, outer. Hydrogen halide, write down. Hydrogen halide reacts with alkene.
So this is a whole new reaction.
Next reaction, yes. Hydrogen halide, HX. Hydrogen halide reacts with alkene and forms alkyne halide. This reaction follows Markovnikov addition. What is Markovnikov rule? It forms, it follows Balkonikov rule. Right on next line. In this reaction, we do not use aqueous solution of HX, hydrogen halide. We do not use aqueous solution of HX because it leads to the formation of alcohol. See, actually what happens, suppose you have an alkene, CH2, double bond CH2. When it reacts with HI, the product, the first one here, you'll get CH2 plus and CH3. And then in the next step, I minus, that acts as a nucleophile attached with these two carbon atoms. And the product is what? CH3, CH2, I. This is the product we get. Now we do not use H2O here. If you use H2O, then what happens in this step? H2O behaves as a nucleophile. Because H2O is a solvent, right? Its concentration is more. And oxygen has lone pair on it. So instead of I minus, this O will attack onto this carbon. And finally, H plus comes out and it leads to the formation of what? CH3, CH2, OH, alcohol, right? That is why we do not use water for this reaction. Okay, we only use HI for this. Okay? What is the product in this reaction? CH3, CH, double bond CH2 with HI. Tell me the product. Done? Okay. Now in this one, the major product is? Okay. Write down. Next one. The addition of HBr, hydrogen bromide. Addition of HBr in presence of peroxide.
Only HBr.
Yes.
Will that like convert back?
This one? No, it's not. It is an irreversible reaction.
So which one is major? Top one is major.
This one is major.
Yeah.
So in presence of?
Addition of HBr in presence of peroxide follows Markovnikov rule, follows anti-Markovnikov rule, and this is known as peroxide effect. Peroxide effect, or we also call it as Kharash effect, K-H-A-R-A-S-C-H. Peroxide effect and Kharash effect, it is applicable only for HBr. Okay, only for HBr. So in this molecule, if you add HBr with H2O2, what is the product we get? So CH3, CH2, CH2Br plus CH3, CH, CH3Br. The major one is Br only, sorry. And this is minus.
So why does it only work with Br and not? Why does it only work with Br and not?
Because in this presence of this, this HBr has some bond length and bond strength. Right. This reaction, why this one is major? Because it follows free radical mechanism. Write on this also. Why it forms this? Because it follows free radical mechanism. H2O2. Then also, the major product is this only. It won't change the product. Okay, because anti-Markovnikov rule is valid only with HBr. Okay, next one, write down. This reaction follows the formation of carbocation, the same one. This reaction follows, here you see, carbocation is forming, right? So it follows the formation of carbocation, hence, wherever possible, we'll do the rearrangement. Okay? Can you tell me what is the product in this reaction? CH3, CCH3. Major product in this reaction.
So here also it's only one to substitution.
One to substitution.
No, so when you shift.
It's also what if I had RDR? Like instead of H, I had R. But I still follow anti Markov.
Addition of RBR. RBR is not, won't go like this. So RBR, we have, it's alkyne-like. We have different reactions. RBR, we cannot add. Carbon bromine bond won't break like this. We have HBR. See, what happens here? Hydrogen, it attacks onto this H+. This pi electron cannot take R group from alkyne-like. Get donated H+ to this electron pair. This attach over here will get a carbon atom. That is not possible when you have RX.
So when this carbon breaks, which carbon will get the electron?
Carbon atom will get. So we always have a tendency to get more stable carbon. So this carbon atom is 1 degree. This carbon atom is 2 degree. 2 degree more
stable. Anyways, we could have done a shift.
Which one? This carbon. Dan, what is the answer? First one?
Second one is wrong.
Okay. Guys, in the first question, this electron pair comes over here and this takes H plus from this, right?
Yes.
So the carbon cation we get is CH3C. CH positive and CH3. Now, this is alpha hydrogen is what? 3. Now to stabilize this, we have rearrangement of carbocation. So one of the methyl group from the hexane carbon takes this bond pair of electron and rearrange itself onto this carbon atom. So 1-2 methyl shift. This gives CH3 positive charge. This is the most stable carbocation we have. If you compare the alpha hydrogen here, 3+3+1, that is 7. Here it was 3. It's more stable. Now in this, Cl- will attach over here. So the tertiary alkylamide will get as a final product here, CCH3. CH3, and OC. This is the product. Okay. Now in this one, what happens? The carbocation is this. Yes. Next, what happens?
So you can apply the dancing resonance. Contract it.
Okay. Now after this, we have ring contraction. Since the positive charge is present on the ring itself, so we have ring contraction here. Ring contraction, how do we do? Suppose this is first, second, third, right, and this one is fourth. It is not required here. So we can take this bond pair. Right. This bond pair of electron, we can say it comes over here, and then this third carbon attached with the second, first carbon. Right. So you see here, we have 1, 2, 3, 3 membered ring. First one is this, second, third one is this, and third, first one has one methyl group. So this is methyl. Right. And third and first are attached. First has fourth, right. So this we have. Two methyl group present here with one positive charge on it. This is the light orange. Here we have positive charge, and this is the fourth carbon. Now you see. Can you understand this? Fine. Understood this? This pair of electron comes on the third carbon, and third and first attached. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, one attached with 4.
So why did you number that?
कैसे भी कर सकते हो number? You can start from the first carbon atom from here. और कैसे भी कर सकते हो? हाँ. You always get this only numbering, but it changes. The product will be this one. Right. You can number like the way you want. Okay. There's no condition for that. No constraint for that. 1, 2, 3, 4, number. We are just numbering it so that we can write down all these, you know, molecules or groups which are attached to the respective carbon. Okay. Now this is, you see, three-membered ring with this carbon as positive charge. So this is stabilized through dancing resonance. The most stable carbocation we have. Nucleophile is what? Cl minus. This Cl minus will attack onto this positive charge carbon atom. The product of this reaction is, we have CH3. Here we have two methyl group with one chlorine. Okay. See, all these things they won't ask you. Question when you have dancing resonance, you have to identify it. Since the point is the reaction involves formation of carbocation. So wherever the carbocation forms, you have to form the most stable possible carbocation. Okay. So what all factors we have, everything will apply. Hyperconjugation, resonance, aromaticity, anything will apply. Right. Now in this one, what is the product we get?
So will it be Cl as a single junction?
This electron pair. I just try it, then we discuss. First we try. The objective is to get most stable carbocation.
You missed one thing.
Ring expansion.
Yes.
Ring expansion.
No, they have this positive over here.
It's also after shifting also.
Jahan tak wo hoga wo every step you should get more stable carbon.
Wait, sir, but I thought you can only shift one.
How can you shift again?
If you shift, you'll get positive here, then this ring will get expanded.
No, but it's not shifting, it's like.
It's expansion, ring expansion after this. We have tried,
right?
Fine, but the angle is still the dominating factor. Ring is expansion.
But you said at every step you have to get a more stable one.
You are taking only hyperconjugation. I am telling you what, this is 4-member ring which is converting into 5-member.
Sir, but then even if that happens next step, you said every step you should get something with more.
No, we'll see. First ring expansion takes place, then we'll see what happens after that.
No, sir, but that's what, before ring expansion takes place, the step before that we have to get more stable.
Yes, yes, we should.
And then
after shifting,
we'll see that. We'll see that. So probably we'll get this.
Angle strain is dominating.
This is positive charge, and this is. You'll get this, right? How many alpha atoms you have here? Three? 3 alpha hydrogen. Now when 1,2 hydride shift, this hydrogen, this comes over here. So we'll get...
No sir, the carbon cation on the other carbon is more stable. So the carbon cation on the second carbon, on the left, more stable.
No,
five, it has five.
So then you can shift it and do all that thing. It's five.
No, no, no. You see, one possibility is this. Another possibility is what?
So it's
we'll get positive charge here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, how many alpha are in here?
Five.
This is more stable.
No, so it's just same, just match that.
So there's no expansion.
No, because see, first of all, the reaction changed with this one. This carbocation is more stable than this one. This will form. Now when shifting is there, it is going towards the less stable state. That's why it won't form. So this is a more stable carbocation that forms in the first step itself. Right? So this gives you minor product, this gives you major product, Cl minus attraction.
So but if it went there, can you draw the
expansion or a thing?
Yeah.
I'll draw that. So for this, suppose with this carbocation.
Wait, so doesn't even go?
It doesn't go.
No, it won't go because this one is more stable.
Wait, so why is it more stable?
That's five alpha hydrogen. That one is three.
Oh man.
If it forms here, right? So in the next step, this will shift over here. And then we'll have expansion, right? How do we write? First here, second, third, fourth, and fifth.
Yes, sir.
Right. So we'll have this thing, let it be. Just you draw five member ring. And first carbon, suppose it is this. So first carbon has one methyl and one this group, right?
Yes.
Okay. First attached with five, suppose this one comes over here. So this is five, this is two, three, and four. Correct? Where will have the positive charge?
Two.
On the second carbon. Will have positive charge here.
So again we can do shift.
Again we can shift this here. We'll get positive and protein attached. But this carbocation won't form because this one is more. Right? Okay, so we'll have some more reaction. We'll finish this next class. So most probably alkyne also will finish next class. Okay, thank you guys.
In this compound and the other one, didn't the other one have 6 alpha?
No, it's 3 only. We have positive charge here.
Yeah.
One here and two here.
No,
something
else.